Well, we've got our hot wire foam cutter set up, and we've been, as you can see all the foam sitting around, we've been working on a capstan, and we have a, well, we've gone back and forth on this thing. Kate talked me into finally fixing the CNC machine.
Yeah, I did.
And doing it that way. Sized it so it will fit there with the clutch, to shove it all the way off. All the way, there you go. And so the clutch, yeah, just barely clears that thing now. So that'll be our capstan, and
something like that.
So we gotta get the CNC machine fixed and start making those things out of foam, we think, or something like that. Well, I was gonna come out and work on my CNC machine, but hey, miracles happened, and it has healed itself. So I think I'll go back and take a nap or something. I think what may have done it was the mouse, because I obviously have a mouse pissing and shitting all over my computer, so he must have known what to do. Hey, Jesus mouse. So first, the first test part, it fits onto the shaft really nicely. I thought I might have to add a little more material to it. It's a little thinner than it should be, though, because that bit has a wobble in it. It's not true, so I'm going to try a different bit. She looks like coming out. Now what we're doing here is we're just lining the stock up. As you can see, by the way, my bit is just a drill bit, nothing fancy to cut foam with. But I'm running a pattern that's just the inside of this, because I've turned this over and I got to get it lined up exactly the way it was on the other side. So that does it for me. You know, just do a little pattern of the hole out there, turn the router off so it doesn't actually run the motor. And now she's lined up. Now I can clamp it down, because see, I got a hole drilled through the table and through this piece of foam. And this piece of foam has some double-sided tape on it. Otherwise, it slips too easily on the painted surface of the steel. So yeah, I don't have to worry about this foam against here, because foam against foam is like, you know, yeah, plenty of friction there. So there, our bolt is in place. And now we just load G-code. Oh, wait, stop. Go to zero. There we go. That's at zero. Load G code. And let's see, flange down. And now it rebuilds the tool path. And it shows up over here. There she is. So that's what we're going to be cutting on the outside of that piece there. We loaded it 0-0, so we're ready to go. We just hit cycle and turn the router back on. You can actually get the glue so hot that it melts the foam, especially if you have a high temp glue gun. I got one of this high temp and then this one. And so if you're not sure, test it, because it really is a shame to lose the part because you melted it.
And then we just measure how much water was displaced. And that'll tell us if we have enough room in our crucible.
All total.
Right.
And now we just have to figure out what the volume is of 11 cups.
But it didn't look scary anymore, because we were worried about 75 pounds of molten material. And
11 cups of water. Looks like we're good, but we'll go ahead and figure out the volume of that. What is it?
So basically we had 11 cups of displacement, which equals out to 50.5 pounds of brass that we'll need. And our crucible holds 75
pounds.
So we have 25 pounds more or less to play with in order to make the risers and the sprues. And since we're
I'm just going to use a pour cup,
right?
And that's going to be the riser.
Right. So we don't need a lot, not like we did with the blades.
So we got 4x4x5 for a riser, and we'll just fill the whole stinking thing.
Yep.
So here's another part we're working on. We're going to have to cut another one because the Jesus mouse did not exorcise the demons from the machine.
No, he didn't.
Yeah, this is it going nuts and cutting the pattern way off.
So the Jesus mouse saved us for one day, but not the next.
Well, maybe he's a fraud.
Yeah, he's like a televangelist, Jesus.
Yeah, could be. But anyway, what I've done is I've switched controllers around, and I installed a new motor on the y-axis, and so we're hoping, and it was working fine after that, but there ain't no telling because it started working before I did any of those changes, so we'll see. It's too bad we didn't film it because we lit Kay on fire, didn't we?
Just a little bit.
A little singed around the edges.
Yeah, we're going to blister here.
Yeah. That's the dangers of lost phone casting. And
learn not to stand downwind. Gauge the wind before you start.
Well, yeah.
That would have been helpful.
But it blew out the side of the mold. Because the buckets really didn't leave enough sand at the top. You know, it filled the riser up and then it blew out. So, we don't know. It could be you're looking at an abortion. In which case, we're sorry. And it could be you're just looking at a newborn child, which they're kind of ugly too.
It really is ugly. Yeah.
Well, on further examination, no, it's an abortion. Because what happened is the mold broke underneath that flange, and the whole side pushed
up
upward, and then the metal shot out on the side here.
Yeah, because you can tell. It's...
What's really bad is now it's a huge hunk of metal that we can't get into a crucible.
Oh crap!
Yeah,
we have to cut it up.
So what's worse is we got to figure out a way of cutting the damn thing up, or plasma.
That sucks.
Yeah, that sucks. There's Jezebel doing her thing. You got some foam on your nose there. Yeah, clean you up there a little bit. And Mike's over, and he's out doing his thing in the garden. And Kay's doing her thing at the sewing machine to repair our summer awning, which is now down because it's almost not summer. And we're doing the foam still because we poured one, and it was a disaster. So we're making some more. We're going to do them a little differently. We're going to do... kind of a lost foam, lost wax thing, but we're gonna get rid of all the foam out of the mold before we shoot it this time. And so that's the two pieces glued together and a hub piece put on it, or an extension, so that it's long enough. And that'll get trimmed back a little bit. And then onto that goes a block that has a wire run through it to give it some lifting strength. And so all this will get dipped in wax and to get a smoother surface, and then it gets dipped in sheetrock mud as an investment. Now, this edge was real thin because I made a mistake cutting, but see, if you dip it in wax several times, it builds up to the same thickness as the rest of them, so wax is also a great way of correcting mistakes. The whole thing goes in, comes back out, try and keep the drift from settling in one spot. I'm going to run my finger across it a little bit, level it out, gets the high spots down. Added some more wax to the pot, so make sure you get all the way onto it. See how it doesn't have anything drip off of it anymore? Hot wax sticks to the cold wax. Just taking off some of those drips that came down the side there.
Take it out. So you can see how much thinner this is. It's real watery.
Well, Kate put the first coat of mud on it today, and then I came back along and added four vents on each of these, and I was sure to cut through the sheetrock, the thin layer of sheetrock mud that was on there, and then hot glued on a piece of foam to come on up, and you'll see that these will get built up as time goes by. But we want the air to be able to vent out of it as the molten metal flows in.
That now makes three coats.
That's right. Worried about the guy behind the camera, aren't you?
Okay, today we get to play in the sand. So I finished dipping the molds one more time with the mud. And so now I'm adding sand to it, which increases the weight quite a bit.
There's the second coat of sand on the capstans, and they're coming along. It'll be like 2 weeks before they're ready to go. And we have news about the Jesus mouse.
Oh,
okay.
Ratón muerto.
Yes, yeah. The Jesus mouse.
Oh, wow.
That's not a pretty sight.
Wow.
You know, Doug didn't think this was going to work.
Yeah, it did.
And now, wow.
You know, I think the Jesus mouse has been dead for 3 days already.
And I did it right.
He's still here. Oh, well. Man, he needs to go out. He is ripe.
Yep.
Hey, come here. You didn't catch the mouse.
Yeah, Earl.
Yeah.
What's up with that, Earl?
Yeah, some cat you are.